Hello everybody and welcome back to another War Thunder video. So after doing tons and tons of challenges and working hard, I finally got my hands on the exclusive I-301 Soviet fighter aircraft, and we're going to take a look at that here in a second. Now, I don't know if I finished all of the total challenges. It's only January... Okay, I don't even know what the date is today. I think it's the 11th. I think it's the 11th, so tomorrow is the 12th. And these challenges are supposed to go until the 12th. And while I just finished today's aviation challenge, which was to fly Italian fighters, and this popped up, and I thought, well, maybe I finished all the challenges, and then it popped up saying maybe you'll get lucky soon, like it always says when you don't unlock the lottery. So I don't know if I finished all the challenges, or if I simply won the lottery, you know, one challenge before they're over anyway. We'll find out tomorrow. We'll also find out when I finish the Ground Forces challenge. So here we are, the I-301. Let's go ahead and take a gander. I left the match early, so piss on me. So here we go, over to the Soviet tech tree, because the Soviets are always plastered with exclusive units. Ah, there it is, Tier 1, battle rating 2.3. Let's take a look at that in the hangar. I like that color. I mean, I don't care much for that color for a plane, but I like how it's all darkish, a darkish red. I like that. That's quite neat. So let's see what it comes equipped. Oh my god. I just saw the weapons on this thing. Oh god. Okay. Oh my god. Okay, so we've got another Russian... Here, you ready to hear the armament, guys? Low tier, 2.3, comes equipped with 250 caliber machine guns, 230 caliber machine guns, and a 23mm cannon. At 2.3. Typical Russian aircraft. And it'll probably fly like a spaceship. Well, there it is. That's pretty much all there is to it. And I had no idea it had such a ridiculous armament for 2.3, Tier 1. But I should have been expecting that. It is Russian. Has it got any armor here? It's got 8mm of armor behind the cockpit. There's its insides. Oh, jeez. Where are the machine guns at, actually? Okay, we got, looks like the 230s back here, the 250s up front, and the 23mm cannon right in the middle. They're all nose-based, which makes it even worse. There you go, guys. I'm going to do the Ground Forces one and see if that's it. So, see you in a little bit. Hey guys, here's just a little add-on to the I-301 video. I wanted to talk a little bit more about the I-301. So, my game finally updated more and boosted its stats. It was 330-something miles an hour, now it's almost 400 miles an hour top speed. This is supposed to be a prototype lag, you know, something that was shit in World War II in terms of the lag standards, and, well, the prototype would be even more shit in most cases. But remember, this is War Thunder, it's developed by Russians, so anything Russian is going to be overpowered and overperforming. So I just wanted to take another look at it quickly. I may repeat some of the stuff I already said. It's got, I'm not even going to talk about the stats for turn time and rate of climb, because I know this thing will climb like a spacer and will turn like a Ryzen. So it's, again, it has 5 guns, 250s, 230s, and a 23mm cannon, and they're all nose-based. So anything here is going to screw you over if he hits you with these. Especially if it's straight on pass, because then all the machine guns and cannon will hit. You know, because remember, they do have different ballistics and whatnot. Well, then again, it is Russian. And it sits at the battle rating of 2.3 in Tier 1. Okay? 4 machine guns, 1 massive-ass cannon. Let's see in the range of battle 2.3 here. Now, that's 3.3. Now, even a 3.3 German plane only carries 2 machine guns and 2 cannons. I'm sorry, that's 4 machine guns. But they're not all nose-based, and they're not German, or they're not Russian cannons. They're the low-velocity German cannon, the MGFFM cannons. It's very ridiculous. That's the point I'm trying to get across, right? It's very ridiculous, the I-301. It's just another pampered-up Russian aircraft that is, you know, under-tiered, overpowered for its tier, overperforming for realistic and simulator. At least I'm assuming it will be. Because, you know, what Russian aircraft isn't? You know, and I mean, again, things that I always complain about is, although I love collecting new aircraft, I mean, look at all the aircraft they've got here, right? All the Soviet aircraft, and there's still a whole bunch I don't even own, like the TU-2, which I should own, but I have to contact Gaijin to get my hands on that. Where I don't have that, you know, there's the TB-3, that's also in here, but I don't have that either. The PO-2 also counts for these. You know, same goes for their army and whatnot. The Germans, they get a sizable ground forces, but for their aviation, it's nowhere near compared to the Russians or the U.S. You know, or I mean, the U.S. doesn't compare to the Russians. The British doesn't compare to the Russians. And the Japanese, well, they're pathetic compared to everyone else. But, you know, they always get pampered with all of the exclusive units and whatnot. Every time there's an exclusive event, you always see an exclusive Soviet, whether the event is exclusively for an exclusive Soviet unit, or if it was like this, where you could get a U.S. unit, and then they had to throw in a Soviet unit. It's just that the basic Russian bias thing. Put an overpowered plane in there just because someone else gets a unit. If the U.S. get a tank, well, then that means the Soviets must have a new unit as well. Or if the Germans get a new unit, then that means the Soviets need three new units. That's just how the system works. Keep an eye open when they release these special events or when they release new premium units in the game. You'll notice that if there's a different country, the Soviets will also get one or more premium or gift units. You'll always notice that. The British actually have quite a few, but there's still some I don't own, like the DB-7 and whatnot. But there you go, guys. Thanks for watching, and join me in the next Worthender video.